Welcome back to JK McLean. Well, I'm working on a well-worn Model 33B. I call it Model 33B, circa between 1954 and 56. I got it as a parts machine. The piston was locked, no spark. There's a ton of white death all in here. But after, a couple of days of trying to work the piston loose, it finally did. Right, spun it around, ring wasn't locked. Was making a decent amount of compression, but hey. So I cleaned up the points, and there was a wire between the points and the coil was all messed up. So I changed that, a little heat shrink tubing. Cleaned up the points, got them gapped, and lo and behold, we have spark. Good. Go on the next step. Fire a little fuel into it, it sputtered over. Looked inside the tank, it's probably the cleanest inside the tank I've ever seen on any 33, 35. I figured, well, maybe this is instead of a parts machine, it's a rebuilder. So I pulled off the carburetor. I've seen a whole lot worse. But we're gonna replace the diaphragm, get it all cleaned up, sanded beneath the reed valve, get it all sit nice. And I'm gonna put the needle back in. Making it a little pretty. Now, the way these things work is as you squeeze the trigger, a little cup goes on the end of this point and pushes the needle down. And fuel, if you ever fitted with an old Tecumseh lawnmower, it has the bowl nut with the little orifice tube on the bottom. It's basically the same principle, through here and out the top. As you give it gas, it pushes the spring-loaded needle down and allows fuel to come out right through that little gap. Do that, work it in a little bit. That's it. All rings go through. Now, they say the way to adjust this, for the most part, is you take the primer rod and you put it in that little hole right there. And when the needle touches that primer rod, you see the primer rod starts to move, you back it off 3 turns and that should set it. Against it. Maybe a little small. Go with what they had for now. Put those in there. pressure against it, stops it from backing out. Over. This is the diaphragm side. Pop the old screen in. And here's the part we really don't want to lose. The whole machine hinges on that little ball bearing. Right in that little hole right there. The whole machine comes to a screeching halt if that little tiny 1/8 inch ball bearing isn't in. Okay, diaphragm. And this part hooks under here. You see this little, this little space beneath it? This bar hooks beneath it. Sometimes you guys put them in. And you can't get that away. This way. Cross. And try to get the diaphragm in there. It's in there. See, get the light. Yeah, it's going to be a little impossible to do. Oh, there we go. I don't know if you can see it sticking out there. That's how it holds everything in place. Anything and lose that ball bearing. Here's the fun part. Get it all back on. This one shot. Up into the back of the carb. Check another carb around here. I can probably show you how to do that. Generally, it's another three-handed operation. Try to get the rod in the right place. Sandwich it all together. First one started. Snugged up. is in. Yeah.